Hello from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's learn about the keto-enol tautomerization, which is an equilibrium that normally strongly favors the keto form over the enol form. In this playlist, we have touched upon the idea of a keto-enol tautomerization in two previous videos. In both, we hydrated an alkyne to give an enol. The enol then quickly converted to a carbonyl, the keto form. One video formed the enol under acidic conditions, the other formed the enol under basic conditions. In both cases, we got the carbonyl, keto form. The keto-enol tautomerization happens readily in either acid or base. Let's look at both mechanisms. In the Markovnikov hydration, that's this top reaction, we treated a terminal alkyne with water, H2SO4, and mercury sulfate. After multiple steps, we got an enol. How did this enol form a ketone? Well, in acid, we protonate, and we'll protonate the alkene. Which side of the alkene will get the proton? We'll protonate the side that gives us the more stable carbocation. That will be the end carbon. So we protonate to get the more highly substituted carbocation. The oxygen can further stabilize the carbocation through resonance. Of the two resonance forms we've drawn, the second is the more stable. You might not like putting the positive charge on the more electronegative oxygen, but the most important rule for drawing resonance forms is satisfying the octet rule. All atoms in the second resonance form satisfy the octet rule. The carbon in the first one does not. We're now almost finished. We can get the keto tautomer just by deprotonating the oxygen. That's it. The mechanism for converting an enol tautomer to a keto tautomer in acid. In the anti-Markovnikov hydration, that's toward the bottom of the slide, we formed an enol under basic conditions. In base, the enol is deprotonated on the oxygen. That gives one resonance form of an enolate. We can move the electrons to draw another resonance form. If we envision protonating this other resonance form, the carbanion will generate our keto tautomer. Now, this product is actually an aldehyde. We'll still refer to it as the keto tautomer, the carbonyl tautomer. That's the basic mechanism. Both of these are very fast and completely reversible processes. The position of the equilibrium is determined by the relative stability of the enol and keto forms. The keto form is generally more stable, so the concentration of the keto form is normally higher at equilibrium. For most cases, the keto form predominates by a factor of about 1,000 to 1. So the keto form really is more stable, and it's typically all you will show as the product.